and welcome to the Learn to Crochet the Easy Way Masterclass. This is a 14-day course that is dedicated to helping you become confident in the basics of crochet and helping you to create everything that you've dreamed of. I'm your instructor, Sigoni, and today we will be learning how to read crochet patterns. Before we get started, make sure to download a free sample of my Learn to Crochet ebook that will be linked in the description box below. For each video in this course, you will find a related page inside the workbook. This workbook is 70 plus pages filled with full lessons, step-by-step picture tutorials, both left and right-handed, checklists, reference sheets, and patterns to both of the projects we will be making in this course. You will also gain access to all of the videos ad-free inside the Teachable platform. Now, on to lesson 7, and this, my friends, is a big one. Nowadays, most people learn through YouTube, which is so awesome. That was me, actually, and it's you too. So I'm so happy that you're here with me and you're allowing me to be a part of your crochet journey. Now, I know that we're here on YouTube talking about how to learn how to crochet, but I promise that once you start really getting into this craft and making all the things that you can, you're going to want to venture off away from YouTube and away from videos altogether, just so that you can work at your own pace, read a crochet pattern, and just find a wider variety of projects that you can create. And that's why learning how to read crochet patterns is so important. Learning how to crochet through video is great because you can see what you're doing right and what you're doing wrong. So, of course, there is nothing wrong with learning how to crochet through video in the beginning, but I promise you're just gonna wanna venture out once you are set free after this course. So, because this lesson is such a big lesson, I've divided it into two parts. The first part, we're going to talk about all the things you need to know about a crochet pattern before you reach the actual pattern. Believe it or not, there's a lot of things you need to know, but I'm going to break it down so it's easy to digest. In part two, we're actually going to make your very first project. So that's exciting in itself. And as we make this project, we're going to be talking about the different aspects of a crochet pattern and how you can use that pattern to also follow along with a video. And that will help you to learn so much easier. So today we're going to cover part one of how to read a crochet pattern. Now you might think the most important part of a crochet pattern is the actual pattern, but in reality, there are so many important things that you need to understand before you actually start crocheting. So that's what we're about to cover. Now the first thing that I want to get into is that these written patterns can be free or paid. And I really don't want you to get into the mindset of only choosing free patterns. Now there are tons and tons of free patterns out there, and as beginners, absolutely go for the free patterns, especially while you're still getting your feet wet and figuring out if this is the craft for you. But just understand that there are also paid patterns, and just because they're paid doesn't mean you should stray away from them. Try not to go into this thinking that everything's gonna be free. If you come across something that is a paid pattern, don't disregard it just because it's a few dollars. That few dollars that you're spending to make something that you love is supporting someone's small business, someone who worked very hard to design this pattern and to write up this pattern so that you too could enjoy this pattern. I just want you to remember that paid patterns are awesome too. Now, the next thing to know about crochet patterns is they can be written in rows and in the round. And we haven't talked about patterns in the round yet, but we will in lesson 10, I believe. So stay tuned for that. Some patterns are worked in the round, some patterns are worked in rows. And that's just something you'll have to keep in mind, and it will make more sense once we get into that lesson. Now, let's get into the pattern. So if you are purchasing a paid pattern, or this is a downloaded pattern, the first thing you will see is a cover page. The cover page will basically have the designer, the name of the pattern, the picture of the pattern, and other important information. Next is the skill level. This isn't available on every pattern, but it is in a lot of patterns. Now, the next part of the pattern that you'll need to understand is the materials and the supplies section. So this is where it tells you what kind of yarn you'll need, hook sizes, notions like stitch markers or tapestry needles and things like that. Depending on what kind of project you're working on, it tells you what you'll need to complete that project. One thing to note in this section is that the yarn that is listed inside the pattern is the yarn that the designer used to design that pattern. It doesn't necessarily mean that you need that exact yarn. It just means that this is the yarn that you'll need if you want to achieve the same kind of look. Generally, if the designer used a medium weight yarn in her design to create that pattern, then you should be okay using a different kind of medium weight yarn. But that's when tension and gauge comes into play. So there's another section of the pattern that will be called gauge, and this tells you how many stitches times how many rows equals a certain amount. Usually it's about a 4-inch square. So you want to make sure that your gauge matches the designer's gauge if you want a similar look. So when it comes to blankets and baskets or something that doesn't really need to be absolutely perfect when it comes to dimensions, gauge isn't as important. But if you're creating something like a garment or a hat, gauge is super important because if you don't have the correct gauge, then it may not fit the way that you would like it to fit. We aren't going to talk about gauge too much in this course, but if there are enough questions or concerns about gauge, I will go ahead and create a separate video for it. Another thing to note when you're looking at the yarn that's used in the pattern is the yardage. If you're using the same yarn, you can go ahead and buy the same amount of balls that the designer used. But if you're using a different type of yarn, you'll want to pay attention to the yardage that's in the pattern so that you can buy enough whenever you're purchasing all of your materials for that specific pattern. That way you don't run out. Then there's abbreviations and special stitches. This is basically your legend of a map. So it's your key, the place that tells you everything that you need to know in order to read the pattern. So crochet patterns are written with a lot of abbreviations because if they weren't, they'd be super long. I mean, pages long. And so that's why we use abbreviations to make it a lot simpler. So this key in the abbreviation section is so important to really understand how to do certain stitches or whatever it's asking you to do in the pattern. And of course, we'll go over all of this in tomorrow's lesson once we work on our very first project together. The last section is the notes section. So this is a place where a designer will place all of his or her notes, and it's important to read this section because sometimes it will talk about if a turning chain counts as a stitch or a certain way to work up the pattern, or it's just a deeper explanation of that project. So that's another important, I mean, they're all important sections to look at, so just make sure that you're reading them all. I said the last one was the last one, but this is the last one. If you are creating a garment or something that has a finished size that you want to achieve, there will be a certain section that tells you your finished measurements and how it should look. If you are creating a garment, you would want to pay attention to this section to make sure that you are working on the right size for you. Now let's talk about rounds versus rows for a second. So this far, we've only been crocheting in rows because that's how I've been showing you how to create your swatches. Later on in the lesson, we will be working in rounds. So working in rows means we're going back and forth, and after each row, we are flipping our work to face the other side and go down the other side. When it comes to working in the round, this is where we're continuously working in the round, so creating a circle of some kind. And we won't be turning our work unless the pattern says so. So there are some patterns that say to turn at the end of a round. It's rare, but it does happen. So pay attention to that as well. Now that's it for all of the information that you need to know before you start reading patterns. Tomorrow we're gonna talk more about, while you're crocheting a pattern, what you need to look for and how to really understand the instructions of the pattern. If I'm talking too fast today, or if you have any questions about reading crochet patterns, just leave them in the description box. Just know that this is a lot of information and you don't have to know it all right now. The point of me giving you this information is just to give you the information, and the more you practice, the more things that you make, the more you will understand how crochet patterns work and how to read them yourself. Also, if you'd like a further explanation of all of the things that I've talked about today, or if you just need something to reference it, the full Learn to Crochet ebook has detailed explanations, especially on this part of the lesson. So if you need that, that will be linked in the description box below. My biggest advice to learning how to read crochet patterns is to find a pattern that has a video, but also has a downloadable written pattern. That way you can read the pattern and follow the video as you go. And that will start to make things a whole lot easier to start reading your own patterns. All right, so that is it for part one of lesson 7 on how to read crochet patterns. In the next lesson, we're actually going to make the checkered washcloth. And I am so excited to share this with you because one, this is our first project that we're going to make together. And two, as we're making this project, I'm going to cover each line of the pattern and show you exactly how to make that through the video. And that's going to give you a better understanding of learning to read crochet patterns. I will also have the instructions printed on the screen so that it's easy for you to follow. But if you'd like the workbook, you can print out the pattern if you want to follow along, or you can pull it up on a different computer or an iPad or something of the sort. Again, check the description if you want to download a free sample of the workbook, as well as links to all of the videos inside this course as they come out. And as always, I'm Sigoni, your instructor, and I will see you in tomorrow's video. Let's get making!